Congress last year required that the issue of binary munitions and our chemical warfare deterrent be examined to see whether there is a need for modernization of the deterrent or not. And you appointed Ambassador Stessel and a distinguished panel of outside former servants and experts in the field to examine the question. They've done so, and they prepared a very thorough report, which Ambassador Stessel would like to highlight the conclusions of today and summarize their views.
Good. Well, Mr. President, as Bud said, we've been at this now for about 8 weeks, trying to respond to the questions posed by the Congress. We do have conclusions which we've reached. Our final report is still in process, should be available very shortly. But we thought we should tell you about our conclusions, which then, if you approve, could be useful in working with the Congress. Now, the Congress asked four questions. One, what would be the effect of modernization of our chemical munitions on trying to achieve a ban on chemical warfare? Our conclusion is that modernization would not have an adverse effect on this effort. On the contrary, it should help. It should be an incentive to the Soviets to move ahead on a verifiable ban. Secondly, we were asked about the adequacy of the existing stockpile to deter the use of chemical warfare by the Russians. Our conclusion is that the stockpile is inadequate for this purpose. It's old. Some of the munitions go back to the 1940s. Much of it is deteriorating. The bulk of the munitions really is useless. There is some small fraction which has some deterrent value, but it's very small. All of the munitions are hazardous to handle. The Soviet capability in this field, as we all know, is very large. We feel that to prevent quick defeat,
you know, we stopped by last night, but you weren't in. I guess you're going on to a movie or something.
You stopped by to see
you. You did?
Oh, sure.
You know, I wanted to thank you.
Gracious. Well, we were in last night and I showed him the fires.
Lord, yesterday was a day that shouldn't have happened to me. Today sounds a bit heavy too.
A little bit, yeah.
Did you see Nancy on the Good Morning Show today?
No.
Oh, she was marvelous on the plane. Get them to run it for you because it was marvelous. She was just fine.
Well, and she never tells me anything.
No, of course not.
You look just wonderful. I feel good. I'm going to mention that perpetually. You've probably forgotten about it. I almost had it, except for the still the
picture. Of course. Did you know what they did in Variety the other day? The random picture. I've never seen it before. Two-column picture of the picture. And then it told what it was. And it said, now tell us the date on another page. They gave the date. I've never seen that in Variety. But they ran a question.
That's a while ago.
1954. 1954. Harry and I